Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to our apartment. I do realize I owe you a full apartment tour still. We moved this apartment just over a year ago and I finally have it finished. So I'm gonna do a full apartment tour while we're all at home now and I have time to actually do it. But today I really wanted to do a quick video. It's gonna be very short and sweet, but I'm hoping that it's gonna be useful and helpful for you. And I wanna show you some really easy, clever, effective organization ideas for small spaces. This apartment is around, I think, 650 square feet. Obviously not huge. It's pretty, like, the storage is pretty good in here. When we moved in, they had done it pretty well, but I definitely had to add in some pieces and make some changes. It's New York City, apartments are small, you have to be very crafty and just get very good at coming up with storage solutions. So I figured I would share them in this video today. I know lots of you also live in small spaces, or you might be new to my channel and just came across this video and this might help you. And I'm interested to see as well, actually, let me know in the comments below, let me know if you rent or if you own your home. And I always think that's interesting and I do have some more video ideas to kind of coincide with that question. So let me know in the comments. And then if you are new here or if you haven't had a chance to already, be sure to subscribe to my channel down below, click the little bell to get notifications. I also have an Instagram called Retro Flame. I post lots of interiors on there as well, lots of fashion, a big mix of stuff, and I would love to have you over there as well. But now let's get into this video. I'm going to talk you through some clever organizational ideas. I'm filming this video on a tripod by myself, so sorry if it's not the best produced video, but you'll get the idea, and I do wanna keep it super short and sweet and to the point. So the first couple of organization ideas I'm gonna show you are in our bathroom. Number one, our under the sink storage. This I actually just perfected a couple of weeks ago, and I honestly don't know how I survived without this. So I added in four different containers. They're all from the container store. The two at the bottom pull out. They each have like their own sections within the bigger boxes. The one on the left is actually all my mini travel items, which is so handy when I have to go on a trip. Hopefully very soon I can just grab things. And it's just much quicker and easier. Then on the right side, I have my cotton pads, extra products, and so much better than what I had before. So I'll be sure to link these exact container store items down below, and definitely check them out if you also have a similar under sink situation. Okay, and then number two, our over the toilet shelving unit. So I actually did not know these existed until I found it in Target. The only storage that was in our bathroom was under the sink, and we do have some shelving behind the mirror, but obviously I wanted to store our towels and I wanted to pop a plant in here somehow. So this shelving unit was the absolute perfect solution. As you can see, we have our towels up there, we have the plant, it's good for decorative pieces. You could definitely add in more baskets or bins on top to have even more storage and really conceal things. A great way to use that space above the toilet. Number three, this new cabinet unit I got for the corner of our bathroom. So this is also actually a new addition. I work in this like influencer world, so obviously I do love to try products. I'm obsessed with hair care and skincare, and I always have lots of spare products, and I just couldn't really figure out a way to store them well before I found this. It's actually from Amazon. It was really well priced. The quality is very good. Wasn't too hard to put together. It has shelves on the inside, so I have everything in categories, and then on the outside there is a few open shelves as well, and I just tried to kind of color coordinate those to keep it as nice as possible. This really has made a huge difference. It fits into the corner perfectly. It's very narrow, so it is a piece that would suit a lot of different spaces, and another piece I 1000% recommend. I actually do have a more in-depth video all about the bathroom makeover that I did and the storage solutions. I also show behind the mirror and the shower and a few other little bits and pieces. So if you do want to watch that, I'll link it down below. Okay, and then for number four, I have moved us into the bedroom, and number four is a shoe wall. And if you're like me, if you have maybe like a smaller bedroom, not that much closet space, but also a lot of shoes, and a big love for shoes, this is honestly the best solution. I had something kind of similar in my last apartment, but this I think is actually better what I've done here. It's just IKEA shelves. I initially actually started off with just 5 for my shoes, and I recently added in an extra one on top for some of my bags. I actually do also have another separate video on how we kind of constructed these, and I show you the whole process and the exact shelves and everything. I will link them down below too, but if you want to watch a separate video, I'll also link that. Number 5 is shelf dividers, and as you can see, I'm here in front of my wardrobe. My wardrobe isn't too bad. There is a decent amount of space, but it definitely needed some tweaks and just some things to perfect it. And these shelf dividers are honestly such a godsend. So as you can see, I fold my trousers. I wish I had room to hang them as well, but unfortunately it's New York and I don't. So I fold all my trousers. I try and keep them as like color coordinated as possible. And then to ensure that I keep them really tidy and to keep the kind of piles separate, I just insert these shelf dividers, and it has made such a difference. I have to tidy this area so much less. It really keeps them in place, and also of course it looks really nice.
Okay, this is a very, very tight corner where I am right now, so I have to hold the camera and show you like this. But number 6 is this sunglass holder. Such a simple idea. I got this on Amazon. I had it in my last apartment as well. I'm pretty sure it's technically for nail varnishes, like, you know, when you go to a salon and they have all the nail varnishes lined up. That's what it's actually for, but it works so perfectly for sunglasses. As you can see, I can fit 3 in each row. You could probably fit like another one if you want to, like 4, just they'll be over each other a little bit, but absolutely perfect for 3 per row.
Next up, the kitchen and organization idea number 7. I have to say the kitchen is probably my favorite area in relation to how I've organized it. We did a bit of a transformation about 2-3 months ago, and I will link that video down below so you can see the whole thing. But one standout product has been our Lazy Susans, which we have on this shelf above the sink. These are the best things ever for utilizing space. You can fit so much on them. They look really slick, really tidy. It just makes you feel very organized, even though it's like the simplest thing ever. It's also great if you're like me and you do have cabinets which are quite high, because you're just utilizing all that space. You're not missing out on any. And these aren't too crazy expensive either. I actually want to get more of these for around the apartment if I can find anywhere else to put them. I love them that much. Number 8, IKEA storage bin. So when you walk into our apartment here, we have a big closet right at the front, and my boyfriend Tommy uses this. I store some coats in there, and it's also our closet for all those other bits. We all have them, that random stuff that doesn't really like need a place in the apartment or in your home as such. You just need to have it like organized away in some corner. So I got these white storage boxes from IKEA. They're really inexpensive. The quality is pretty decent in fairness for the price. And we just have them lined up on the top shelf of this closet. It's obviously not the most fancy way of doing things, but it works really well for us. I am actually going to label them all. I only have 2 labels on there right now, so ignore that. But there will be labels all across. We have our bedding in here, spare interior pieces, summer clothes. Like, it's just such an easy way to do it. And then you could also actually use these storage bins under the bed if you have a couch, a sofa that you can fit things under. They're really versatile and really handy, and yeah, I've had these even since our last apartment. They're amazing. And then last but not least, number 9, baskets. I have an obsession with blankets, and obviously we have a cream couch in our apartment, so I love to have blankets on the whole time if we're eating or if I have people over or whatever, just to protect it. So obviously I've got a lot of blankets, and instead of just having them thrown around the place, I got this basket from Serena and Lily. I actually had wanted this basket for so long. It's kind of one that you see a lot on Instagram, and some people that I follow have it. It's so beautiful. The quality is amazing. A little bit pricey, but I will say it's something that I'll have forever. So yeah, if you have some annoying things that you know you need, but you don't want to be on display or like thrown around the place, baskets would be your best friend, especially for the bedroom as well. And that's it, guys. They are my easy, clever organizational ideas that I personally find so helpful in my home. I hope you got some ideas. If you do recreate anything or use anything from this video, be sure to tag me on Instagram @retroflame. I would love to see how you do it, or if you have any of your own ideas, tag me as well, because I'm always looking for more organizational solutions. I have a feeling I'll be in New York for a good bit longer, so I'm pretty sure I'll be doing these kind of videos for a long time to come, but hopefully you enjoyed anyway. Be sure to answer the question that I asked at the beginning of the video. Let me know in the comments if you either rent or buy your home. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.